He holds my future. My life is wild and it be just because of me. Because of me.
Because of me.
I confess.
I confess.
So it's something you want to do. I say,
oh, fear is
gone. And now I know,
because I know,
he holds my future.
He holds my future.
And
life is one, and living just because he lives.
Give me the option to function that I may blow in the secrets of your revelation. And I pray that Father may use me as a vessel. And God's people say,
amen.
God's people say,
amen.
Come on, and God's people say,
amen.
Okay, now listen to me. I want to be, actually, to begin with a testimony. I never wanted to enter that because I wanted to be Christ's life. It was on Sunday at night, and then I was coming from the house, and then jumping on the veranda, and then coming back, I see a snake, it was hissing. So I hurriedly got a stick, and then I bit it. But actually, I just wondered, I got from the house, and then coming back, I saw the snake. It would have bitten me. But because we have God's protection, no one can come against us, we also
have.
Some 5 minutes because I just received a phone call from one of my friends, and they have given me a blessing for university in Kenya because I'll be leaving. If not this week, then the coming week I'll be leaving for Kenya to study theology. I'll be leaving to study theology. I'll be doing the degree in theology, and then I'll go for the master's. Theology, you know the course which Pastor Philip did?
Yes.
That's the course I'm going to do. Yeah, and also I'll do the business course. Somebody say. So for 4 years I've been doing theology, and then I've opened a master's for 3 years. And then everything is gonna be good. Come on, somebody. God has a better plan for you.
Amen.
Amen. Okay, let me begin like this. God is raising a generation of youth around the world. They passionately love God. They are energetic. They are creative, committed, and open pioneers. I am under you that God is raising. God is raising the generation of you. They know their God, culture, and language. They want to raise people the gospel of the kingdom, and they want their lives to be counted for something, that I mean something for the kingdom of God. They seek discipleship, training, and a shared commitment of accountability, support, and encouragement. They save rivers and make this one the manifest for Christ in this generation. Do you want to manifest for Christ in this generation?
Yes.
You want to manifest?
Yeah.
They want to know God's vision for their lives and why stop and do it. They are eager to do God's way. They say, we shall do God's way. And then the scripture says, may God's will be done on earth as it's done in heaven. They will never compromise with the standards, lifestyle, and the setup of this world. But their main focus and desire is to do the will of God.
Amen.
Come on, somebody say
amen. Amen.
God is raising the generation of you. They want to be the light of the world and the soul of the earth. They want to reach the darkest hearts of the people with the light of the world, and that is Jesus. And they want to be the soul of the earth so as to feed this world with the salty taste of God's word. Because God, because the world needs the light and the soul. And that is Jesus. The world has seen money. The world has seen many people, many people, the world is still yearns to see that under the person God is going to use. Come on, somebody say it.
Amen.
These are the people who want to be discipled. They want to be trained and also rise up and disciple others to make a difference for God in this world. And you must be among those people. They are leaders. And their manifestation is not for some time, for some future time. But it's just now. Tell your neighbor, it starts with you and it starts now.
It starts with you.
Come on, do you want to be among those people?
Yes.
These are the people who have the word of life and they are empowered by the Holy Spirit. And their time is now. We must see them. But what they need to be confident, looking at the author and the finisher of their faith. And that is Jesus.
Amen.
My sermon where I is prayer. Where the title of my sermon is today is all about being confident. Tell your neighbor, being confident.
Being confident.
Recently, before we had a prayer session on Saturday, my mentor, Pastor Michael, talked about being absolute confidence. But actually, I just want to go deep in that, and I just want to give one scripture. We want to go deep in that scripture. And let us go to Philippians chapter 1, verse 6. Somebody can raise up your hand. You're ready for us. God will bless you. Philippians chapter 1 and verse 6. Somebody that.
Philippians
chapter 1 and verse 6.
Praise God.
Amen.
Being confident of this very thing, that you who began a good work in you will complete it.
Come on, somebody. Thank you. Thank you, my brother David. Let us laugh for David. Let us laugh for David. So the Bible goes on to say, be confident of this very one thing, that the God who began a good work in you will accomplish it. It says by saying, be confident. Because it goes on to say that the God who began a good work in you. Now let us try to analyze the scripture. Being confident is a present continuous, that is present continuous tense. You do remember high school and then also primary school? Past participle, past tense, you remember? But this one is a present continuous tense. It tells you that you need to have a strong belief always, and daily belief always. Being confident that the God will be God and will do what you need. And I like what Pastor Michael said. It means to have total trust, total belief in God. Doesn't matter what you face, doesn't matter what you see, but keep on continuing the journey. It will mean that the journey might not be easy as you think. That's why he says that, you know what? Be confident. But God will begin a good work in you. Will accomplish it. You might even lose your progress, but be confident. You might even get a demotion, but be confident. You might even get an accident, but be confident. You might even get sick, but be confident. That sickness won't kill you, that you'll be promoted one day, that you'll rise up and then become a great man and then a great woman in this world. Just be confident in God.
Amen.
Amen. So, be confident. There is a day when sorrow will end. When you give a testimony also, when you get married also, because we serve a God who doesn't fail. Because of his life, never told the children after the house of Jacob to seek me in vain. Amina, are you there, people?
Yes.
So now listen to me. We are talking about being confident that the God who began a good work in you. Who began a good work in you? Is it money?
No.
Is it a boyfriend?
No.
Is it your parents?
No.
Is it your energy? Is it your wisdom? Is it your academics?
No.
Yes, they can begin. But actually, I can't guarantee that they can end it. They can push you to this thing. I can't guarantee. But I can guarantee that when God begins a good work in you, you will totally reach your destiny. That's what I can guarantee.
Amen.
That's why the psalms goes on to say, I'll rise up my eyes upon the hills. Where shall my help come from? How did God begin a good work in us? How did God begin a good work in us? This is how it began. I never knew about Christ, but actually, I just believe in as my personal Savior and Lord. So it began a good work in me. So how does God begin a good work in you? You repent and confess sin as your personal Savior. After doing that, you enter a new family, you become a new preacher, you get a new DNA. Where diseases can defeat you, where curses can defeat you, where the demons can defeat you. Because in this family, they are not devils. When devils come, we chase them away because we have the power of God and the power of the Holy Spirit. So when devils come, we chase them away.
Amen.
Nina. Now, let me wind up like this. Wind up. Okay, so, being confident, God will begin a good work. A good work in you is this. We have a bad work that we used to live in. We have a bad work, it's here. We have a good work, it's here. But when you confess and then believe in Jesus as your personal Savior, trust the word, you are no longer a sinner, you are no longer a drunkard, you are no longer a liar, you are no longer a prostitute, because you cross the border, you are a new family, then God gives you the good work. So what I can tell you is what? Keep on praying, keep on believing God, keep on worshiping God, and I know one day He will make you to accomplish. So let me get this. Where does confidence come from? Confidence is a power. This is where it comes from. Reading and then meditating about God's word. That's why Joshua, in Joshua chapter 1 and verse 8, God goes on to tell Joshua, you know what? May this book of the law never depart from my mouth. You shall meditate upon it day and night, so that you may observe to do according to what is written in it, so that you may have your word prosper. Number two, loving and knowing your God. The Bible goes on to say, those who know their God, they shall be strong and they shall do mighty exploits. That is in the 2nd chapter 11, verse 32. The reason as why Peter got up from the boat, it is because he knew Jesus. Do you know Jesus? I love it, my pastor. I love it, Yahweh. Who is Jesus to you? Peter, I love you. Number three, having an encounter and an experience with God. That is the third one. So may God bless you.
Amen.
I wish you a nice time. I want to thank my pastor and also my mentor for giving me this time. Just keep on being God. God will give me the lecture. Never lose one. Keep you inspired.